coasted in. It sounded like a Tesla because there was no noise. It was just like, whew. Only it was a beat up old car and this guy was out of gas. I'm not one to judge him. That's, you know, most of my cars are beat up old cars. And so he rolls right in and he comes over and he's got like a, I'll never forget, his face was really red. Is my volume okay? Yeah, okay. Yeah. And he comes up and he says, hey, can you, he landed this thing right next to the pump. And he said, I'm out of gas, my car's leaking gas, I don't have any money. Can you give me some gas money? And I said, I'll put some gas right in your tank, brother. And so I just went over and I started pumping his tank, and he was so grateful. Really, really grateful. And I just was telling him, I was like, it's Jesus, man. It's Jesus, he loves you. And we started talking, and it turns out he was a Catholic. We hadn't been to church in years. And he was really insistent, like, this is so kind of you. And I was really insistent, this is Jesus, and he loves you, brother. And gave him, like, the miraculous medal, and he was intent, thank you, Jesus, on going back to church after that encounter. And a few days later, the Lord brought it up in prayer. He brought the whole incident up again. And when I was saying to this man with conviction, this is Jesus. It's Jesus. It's his. He loves you. The money is his. And the Lord Jesus, like, brought it up, and he just put it right on my heart. And he was letting me feel. You were saying those words. You believe those words. But I want you to feel the reality. And he was just pressing into my heart. And I was just realizing, like, oh my gosh. He really does live in me. Jesus said to his apostles that they needed to be clothed with power on high to do the mission. We all know the mission of the church. Jesus said, say, go, make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them all I've taught you. But he told them, stay in Jerusalem until you are clothed with power from on high. And the power is the Holy Spirit. And the word there for power, if you haven't heard this, it's so good. You'll be clothed with power on high, from on high. Luke 24:49, Acts chapter 1, verse 8. That word power, does anybody know it? This is going to be fun. Dunamis. Dunamis. You just got to say it three times, ready? Dunamis. 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 Dunamis is where you get the word dynamite. Dunamis. The biblical definition of dunamis. First, it's, okay, one more time. What is the power that's poured into us? Yeah. Flowing from the Father and the Son, the love of God fills our hearts. It is the person of the Holy Spirit. Sorry. I might have set that up wrong. So usually I don't get a good answer because I didn't ask the question, right? Take it up with my English teacher. That's on me. Yeah, study. So, okay. Dunamis. The biblical definition is the power belonging to something by virtue of what it is. The power belonging to something by virtue of what it is. And what it is God. The Holy Spirit. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 17. The Spirit is the Lord. And that word there, Lord, always covers up Adonai. Adonai always covers up Yahweh, the sacred name. When Paul writes, the Spirit is the Lord, God is revealing that the Spirit, he is the third person of the Trinity. It's Jesus at the Last Supper referred to him as a person. He's going to. So the power that belongs to something by virtue of what it is. And what it is who it is, it is God. The second aspect of dunamis in the biblical notion, the scriptures, is the power to work miracles. That makes sense. If you've got God in you, and Jesus said, ask for whatever you want in my name. With faith the size of a mustard seed, you can move a mountain. I haven't seen a mom move, but I saw a lady's leg get healed tonight. There's been times it doesn't happen, but I know the father's like, way to go, son. No. I'd rather get mustard on my face and drop my hot dog than not even try, you know? So that is a good experience. When you blow, when you don't do it, you know God is calling you to tell somebody God bless you, ask to pray to somebody, and you don't do it, and I go home and I just burn. And then the next day you're just like, okay, I'm ready, God. Power. We have so much power because He's in us. So one more time, just look at the person next to you and say, you have dunamis! 1, 2, 3.